let's talk about pain. Pain is not a fun experience felt by people. But there's some of the ways you can limit pain in the body are things like decreasing neurofiber conduction or reducing inflammation or stuff like that. And some of these, or the three that we're going to talk about, are decreasing pain through the gait control theory, endogenous opiates, and then central biasing. The first one, gait control theory, or the old theory, is about decreasing pain through affecting the ascending pathways of pain perception in the body, so like the afferent signals to the brain. And the how this works is the reason behind it is you're blocking the nociceptive pathways, the pathways that are send painful signals in the body, by stimulating the non-nociceptive pathways, so like the A-beta fibers, in order to block C fibers from eliciting pain. So an example of that would be like rubbing your arm after getting hit. So it's basically blocking that ascending pathway to the brain to elicit the non-painful, or feeling of not having pain. Then endogenous opiates and central biasing are the two that affect the descending pathway of pain perception, as opposed to the gait control theory. So these are like the kind of the newer additions to it. So with endogenous opiates, the brain stimulates the pituitary gland and blocks the pain transmission by not allowing depolarization to occur. So it's like higher centers down. In this system, pain control, stimulation of the A-delta or the C-fibers or both results in the body's production of endogenous opiates that will produce like an analgesic response in the body, blocking noxious stimuli, so like blocking painful stimulus. Bottom line is, like a noxious stimulus through the A-delta and C-fibers activates that descending pain control mechanism, so the efferent pathway. And then last one, with central biasing, it's the brain, so like hypothalamus stimulates transmission cell in the dorsal horn, blocking pain transmission but not allowing depolarization to occur. So in this one, the A-delta and the C-fibers transmit pain impulses up to the thalamus, and the thalamus and brainstem send impulses along the efferent fibers back to the dorsal horn, which these impulses act to inhibit transmission, closing the T-cell, like the TRAC cell. Blocks impulses from the first order neurons to the second order neurons. The second order received, but it didn't deliver. So the bottom line of that one is you're stimulating of the descending pathway, so the efferent pathway and the dorsolateral tract of the spinal cord, due to the A-delta and C-fiber afferent impulses that are already received in the higher centers, results in a blocking of further impulses carried along through the tract. And that is pain control.
Woo! Thanks, Bob.